Let's begin. Hi everyone! In this video tutorial we are talking about SUMIFs and COUNTIFs formulas. So let's dive in. In this worksheet we have a sale report of drugs, buyer's name and country, order data and price of each drug. We want to write some formulas that will help us summarize the data based on specific conditions. I have prepared two different criteria for you, in which we will write the formulas to find the amount and the number of sales, based on this criteria. For example, the condition here is these two drugs, so we want to find the total sales for that. We all know that this can be easily found using data filters. Turn on the filters and select amoxicillin under drugs and United States under country. And the total sales can be found easily using the SUM formula. But this method might not be applicable in a particular situation where conditions change dynamically. The syntax of SUMIF's formula is the following. So it takes the sum rates from where you want to sum, and it takes multiple criteria ranges and the criteria. In general, this formula is a plural form of the SUMIF formula. Let's go back to our example. The sum rates is the price column, and the criteria rates is the drugs column, where the criterion is amoxicillin. You can specify multiple criteria ranges and criteria. In our example, we have second criteria rates, country, where the criterion is Germany. Let's type equal SUMIFs E2 to E31, A2 to A31, amoxicillin, C2 to C31, and Germany, which is the last criterion. And enter. Once we press enter, Excel evaluates the total amount for us based on the criteria we have specified. The result is 31. Let's make another example here. And enter. The result is 50. To make it more interesting, I will add one more criterion. I'll calculate the sales for March 2017. So I'll use the date value formula, like this. Nice. Now let's talk about COUNTIFs formula. It is the same formula as we used in the SUMIFs example, but instead of summing, we are just counting. In this case, we have the following. The same here. Both formulas are used in dashboards and are very powerful and simple to understand. If you want to ask questions, I'll be more than happy to help you. Thank you, and I will see you in the next lesson. Bye!